and welcome to this session where we are looking at East Africa's tech response to the COVID-19 outbreak. Now, of course, the ongoing outbreak is having business implications across sectors, across industries, geography, many of which are yet to be fully felt or even understood. But what we do know is those who quickly adapt to what is now well known as a new normal are already seeing the benefits. The session will explore how the outbreak has affected East Africa and, of course, what it could mean for the digital ecosystems of the future. I'd like to introduce my panelists who are joining us this afternoon and, of course, come from a wide sector of sectors, from government to the private sector, to health as well, and trade. Dr. Catherine Gitao, she's the CEO of the ICT Authority of Kenya. Catherine, thank you so much, Dr. Catherine, for joining us on this session. Philip Figo, Director for Africa, Thunderbird School of Global Government, Global Management. Philip, thank you so much for making time to join us. Phyllis Mwangi, National Coordinator, ITC She Trades. It's a pleasure to have you here with us. And John Kamara is the CEO and founder of Afia Records. Ladies and gentlemen, it's an absolute pleasure to have you here with us. Of course, an absolutely necessary conversation in the times that we're living in. And as I did say in the intro, it is those of us within the different sectors that we operate in that quickly adapt that will be the winners at the end of the day. So I'd just like to quickly kick us off with a very short response from you in terms of what your outlook has been so far in how East Africa has responded, especially looking at the tech space to the COVID outbreak. And I'd like to start with the Figo. Philip?
The response has been unprecedented to the extent of how East Africans have been able to adopt their culture of collaboration and using technology to sort of catalyze that action towards responding to COVID-19. We have seen in our case, for example, we are basically a public research university, and our mode is really to assume fundamental responsibility of the communities which we serve. So as a neutral actor, issuing out a call of simply saying, what can we do collaboratively? We got an overwhelming response to the extent that we had global companies who are based in Kenya around technology, who are able to work with techies who are also in Kenyan innovators, who are then able to collaborate with a government that was very clear that COVID-19 is all in, everybody must be part of this, to funders who are willing to put in money. So my sense is that we saw something new. And the new thing was that collaboration across sectors, silos were broken very quickly. We're able to see data being shared initially that wasn't normal, even though the conversations, of course, that we must have around privacy and around that. But my sense was that there seems to be a willingness already and a culture of collaboration, but also a culture of agility, which we need for the future of work, because technology is about agility and expediency. That has been our experience the last couple of months.
Thank you, Philip. And I'm glad you've mentioned collaboration. As an entrepreneur myself, who had been thinking of opening, a shopfront for our skincare business, COVID taught us, threw us off to a completely different direction. And it is collaboration with tech companies that have now meant that our business, for instance, is now 90% on the digital platform and only 10 on a face-to-face. And that takes me to you, Phyllis. ITC She Trades, which has been doing an incredible job around the trade space in Kenya, with many women now looking at the international markets. And with the coming in of the AfCFTA, of course, now women looking at Africa as a market, and COVID teaching us even more that it's easier for me to sell something to Uganda than it is to sell to, to the UK, for instance. How has this time been for you sitting at She Trades?
Thank you, Terri-Ann. This season has been absolutely phenomenal. It's interesting. They say that there's a women quote that goes out there that says, if you're not seated at the table, then you're probably on the table being eaten as lunch. So I represent ITC She Trades, benefits. And we all know that the SDGs, each for equal, you know, this March, we had a lot of publicity around putting women at the forefront, not necessarily because of our favor, but because the time has come. And even the men are supporting this and saying, yes, our sisters, our wives, our daughters need to just take that, need to really do what they need to do. Now, so at ITC on the She Trades Commonwealth Project, we have been dealing with four sectors, which is in agribusiness and textile and apparel. Those are two in product. And then we have two in services, which is IT and BPO, women in IT and BPO, and women in tourism. And just as I'm mentioning it, I'm sure your mind is just gravitating towards, did you say tourism? Yes, I said. So we took a pause. Of course, everyone has been hard hit, but tourism was the first one to feel the impact immediately. Deals signed, you know, money on the table, money in the bank, and customer says, I'm not coming. The visa cannot be processed. The flight has been canceled. So they were the first ones to go through that. And what we've done, what we've seen in East Africa and with the community that we're working with is definitely a need for product development, need to look Kenya and need to look East Africa and need to look regional. So some of what we've seen happening is the, you know, some of the women in tourism would not really think about the regional market, the African market, but now it's a complete shift into local and regional. And yes, we know that international tourism will come back. We are very optimistic about that, but we are almost sure that at least 30% of it will begin to go to the regional market because there's a new appreciation. What we've done is product development, pricing for, you know, the sector. Let me move into IT and BPO. Some of the things we've seen women do with the IT and BPO sector is amazing. Most of them have built digital platforms. In fact, we have some that are pitching at East Africa Com, pitching their new ideas, pitching risk management apps, because, you know, COVID risk was so great that, you know, nobody ever really could have prepared for this kind of magnitude. So they have developed apps just to measure your risk, make decisions, you know. Others have developed e-commerce platforms. Others have developed agri-tech, especially the space of agri-tech. We have some really amazing, you know, ideas coming out of the women. So you can see if youth